Hello, I'm Todd Lewis from Fiasco Sports, reporting for the SA Footballer magazine. And today I'm joined by Luke Stubing, the coach of the Smosh Westlakes Division 2 side. And Luke, you had a tough loss on the weekend.
We did.
Lost by 85 points to the Scotch Old Collegians.
Yep. We've had a great pre-season. We've recruited, I guess, you know, three or four players to the club that we think are going to have a really big impact and really improve our side this year. And our expectations were to go down there and have a good win. So, round one, serves up some surprises from time to time and definitely it didn't go the way we wanted it to. But, you know, there was, you know, the margin 85 points, it sounds ludicrous to think that there's some simple things for us to fix. It sounds like it's more than that. But I really do think there are a few simple things that we can fix, and then if we had those things in place earlier in the game, you know, the game got away from us for sure, but we could have been in the game for a lot longer and perhaps had a chance to win it if we did some things differently. So, look, the personnel's there, and we've just got to go back to work this week and fix it up.
Yeah, so what are a few of those things that you think you got to work on this week? Were there certain things that definitely stood out to you?
Yep, definitely. Just the way we held our width outside the stoppage. So, Scotch were really well organised and consistently got the ball out neatly. I thought we did a reasonable job of getting our hands on the footy, but just didn't seem to have those guys. You know, we've got the roles set up outside the stoppage, but I just didn't think we did it consistently well, and just lost our structure around the footy. We're a bit. They had an excellent forward line, and one of our really good key defenders was out. And we just lost, we lost a lot of contests in our back 50 that normally we'd compete and bring the ball to ground or take a grab. So just probably those two things alone would have definitely helped us out.
Yeah, no worries. And just having a look at some of the other results, Modbury defeated Broadview by 35 points. Garza had a massive win over Jepps Cross by 132 points. PAC Old Collegians defeated Walkerville by 69 points, and Unley Mercedes Jets defeated St. Peter's Old Collegians by 42 points. Was there anything that surprised you there a lot, or are they the results you expected?
Yeah, look, I think we're all aware that Gazer have had some good recruits and a new coach in Bob Cross, and I think everyone's aware that they're going to be a great side this year. So I think they'll be the 100 side in the competition, but traditionally, particularly over the last two or three years, Div 2 has been very, very tight. And so to see margins like that was pretty surprising. There's got to be a winner and a loser, but I would have thought, 20, 30-point margins would have been more like it. So there was a couple of blowouts there, including ours, unfortunately.
Yeah, and obviously a tough loss on the weekend, but you'd be looking to put that behind you and bounce back. So what are your overall expectations on the season? And has anything changed after the weekend, or are you still striving towards ultimate success?
No, definitely not. Nothing's changed as far as my expectations, and we spoke about that straight after the game. Footy, you have your ups and downs in footy, and sometimes that's in the shape of a big loss, and we had one on the weekend, but my expectation is to play finals. That hasn't changed one bit. I guess I was disappointed with some individual performances, and there was parts of the way we coached on Saturday where we can definitely improve, but my expectation is to play finals footy, and that hasn't changed.
Obviously, it was a tough loss. You lost by a big margin, but were there any performances that did show some good, promising signs for the weeks coming? Was there anyone that stood out to you or surprised you on the weekend?
Yeah, well, we had Charlie Ray, who's been our full forward for a few years. We tried him at centre half back, and he was really good in that role and threw him on the ball a bit. So that's added something for us that we didn't know we had. Lachlan Pink, who's always been a back flanker for us, he played up on a wing and played some really good footy. So there are two individual performances that were quite good. Some of our new guys just a bit slow to start, and I think that's just playing with a new group of guys. That's not uncommon to have that. We've got Chris Molitor, our big ruckman, back after a knee reco last year, and he's going to be better for the run. Has definitely played better footy, but just that game under his belt's a good thing for us.
Okay, thank you, Luke. That's been Todd Lewis from Fiasco Sports reporting for the SA Footballer magazine. I've been joined by Luke Stubing from the Smosh Westlakes Footy Club in Div 2, and he's done our weekly roundup.
Thanks, mate.